Arriving back in Camden Town on a very sandy carpet, Anthea explains to her disbelieving mother that Cook has decided to stay on as queen of a desert island. She meets the members of the church bazaar committee, and hearing of her plight, takes pity on the unfortunate Miss Peasmarsh. The carpet flies them to a Rani's palace in India, where they are unwittingly able to do the Rani a good turn also. They return to the church bazaar in the nick of time with the carpet laden with exotic gifts. However, the day ends in a disaster for the children when Miss Peasmarsh sells their carpet at the bazaar.
How did you get on, Mrs. Simpson?
Oh.
I see that you've almost cleared your stall. What do you think of this? I picked it up for 10 shillings. I do believe it's genuine Persian. It's a bit stained, of course. I think I could have got it for less, but I do believe in being generous to the church bazaar. Such a worthy cause. What do you want, boy?
The carpet. What I mean is, we brought it, you see.
You brought it? I understood it was Miss Peasmarsh's cousin who brought it.
Brought it for her cousin. Well, what I mean is, we meant to buy it.
Indeed.
And we'd like to buy it from you. We'll pay you...
Certainly not, boy. Go away. Good afternoon, Mrs. Simpson.
Well, what do you think of that?
We can't let her keep our carpet.
Our magic carpet?
We've got to get it back, by hook or by crook.
What do you mean, by crook?
He means steal it back.
Steal it? It's not stealing, it's ours.
And she only paid 10 shillings. It cost Father £1.2 and 9.
Stealing is stealing.
Panther's right. We can't burgle Mrs. Biddle's house.
Why not?
We don't know where it is. We'll soon find out.
Oh, please, don't let's burgle. Let's just go and speak to her again.
What if she still won't give us the carpet?
Then we'll see. I say, excuse me, Mrs. Simpson. Could you tell us where Mrs. Biddle lives, please?
Not bad. Not bad at all. Worth £5 at least. Who could that be? Well, answer it, Trindle. There's a bad stain here. Never mind, the table will cover that.
We want to see Mrs. Biddle, please. Right away. And please don't tell us she's not at home.
Who is that? It's you lot again, and what are you doing here?
We want our carpet.
Your carpet?
You only paid 10 shillings, and it's...
That's enough! Brindle, you can go. And you can go too, at once, but all of you.
But please!
Another word! Off you go at once, or I shall call the police.
It's no use.
Please don't be angry. We need the carpet so badly. We can find 12 shillings between
us. How dare you come here pestering me?
You do look horrid, don't you?
What?
All horrid and cross.
You are an exceedingly rude child.
Jane, you shouldn't mind.
Let's push ourselves home.
No!
We can't do that. The carpet would take her as well. She'd go raving mad.
I give you 1 minute to get out of this house.
I do wish. I wish you were nice and kind and good-tempered and...
Oh!
What?
Oh, dear.
What is it?
I felt quite curious for a moment. It's all right now. I feel better now. Yes, I feel much better now. What were you saying, my dear?
About the carpet.
Oh, the carpet. Of course you want it yourselves, don't you?
Oh, yes, please, please.
You see, it's ours, was ours, and we're very fond of it.
Well, of course you must have the carpet, my dear, since you've taken such a fancy to it.
We'll pay you the 12 shillings.
Oh, no, no, only 10. That's all I paid for it.
I say, you are a jolly good sort.
Well, that's a very nice compliment, young man. Thank you. And now do roll it up at once.
We're so grateful. You see, really, it was our carpet, and it got sold by mistake.
By mistake? Oh, but how dreadful. In that case, we shall say no more about the 10 shillings.
But you paid.
I know, but we'll call it a donation to a worthy cause.
Well.
That reminds me, I must tell Miss Beesmart what a lovely stall she has. So much nicer than mine. I say, do you think she's fond of Mr. Bolam?
Yes, I think she is, rather.
Goodbye. Thank you.
I think I shall make an excuse not to help at the next parish meeting, and then she can do it instead. Perhaps they'll get married. Oh, they'd make such a lovely couple.
Oh, Mrs. Biddle, you are a very sweet person.
Oh, my dear, thank you. It's been such a long time since anyone's... Do you know, I'd quite forgotten what a pleasure it is to make people happy. Why had I forgotten? I promise I shall never, never forget again.
Just look at the weather.
It isn't worth looking at.
Pray, continue with your display.
All right. This one is Betty.
Mm-hmm.
And this one is Molly. Isn't she pretty?
Passable.
I'm so glad you're awake again. You're much better company than the carpet.
Well, since you mention it, I suppose I do have a certain conversational fluency.
Oh, yes. And you can talk to people, too.
It doesn't matter what the weather's like here. We can go somewhere else, on the carpet.
Of course! Shall we go to the North Pole?
That's even colder than here.
Let's go to the equator.
No, we went there before. To the island. I think the diamond mines of Golconda would be nice.
But what?
Where?
Don't you think so, Janie?
No, I don't.
If you cannot agree among yourselves, I fear I may have to leave you.
All right. You decide where to go.
Yes, you decide, please.
Well, if I were you, I would give the carpet a rest before you lose the use of your legs. Since I have never visited these parts before, I should like you to take me out and explain your ugly metropolis.
Ugly what?
He wants us to show him London.
Most of all, I wish to see one of my temples. I gather from the carpet that I have many temples in this land dedicated to my worship.
How can you gather anything from the carpet?
You can gather many things from a carpet.
Like dust?
If you know how.
Well, why not show him London?
I'll tell you why not. It's raining.
Oh, I cannot say that I am fond of rain. Have you no invocation to banish it?
Oh, you mean... Rain, rain, go away. Come again another day. Little baby wants to play.
That lot of you said it. Never does go away.
I am not surprised if you say it in that tone of voice. Allow me to try.
So he thinks he can change the weather now, does he?
All right, then. You show us what you can do.
If the sun knew that I was here, he would shine at once. He likes shining on me. I look so bright and golden. Please do not think that I am boasting. I merely state the facts. Now, let me think. Yes, I have it. Listen to this. Shine, great sun, the lovely fee. Nix is here and wants to be shone on, splendid sun, by thee.
That's poetry.
Well, sort of.
I was obliged to put in lovely to make the line long enough.
There's plenty of nasty words just the same length.
Shine, great sun, the lovely fee, Nix is here.
Oh, look!
Come on, Bobs.
I'm coming. over.
I think we should go back.
That's the Tower of London. It was built by the Normans after they conquered England.
A very poor assortment of domes.
Well, what do you think of that?
A temple?
Not exactly. It's St. Paul's Cathedral.
I know a temple when I see one.
It isn't your temple.
Oh.
But it has a lovely dome.
I do not like it. Move on. That is an improvement. What is this supposed to be?
It's a monument to the Fire of London.
Fire? Did you say fire?
The whole city was burned down in 1666.
How I wish I had been here. I would have enjoyed that.
Squirrel, are you sure this is the right way?
Yes. Well, of course I'm sure.
It's always the same as shortcuts. They never take you where you think they will.
Yeah.
Well, what are they laughing at?
I think.
Oh, beastly rude.
It's you girls' fault coming out in those flashy coats.
I thought we ought to dress up a bit. Going out with Phoenix.
Quite right, too.
Hey, miss! Where did you get that hat?
You keep your mouth shut.
You get your haircut.
I wish I could think of something nasty enough to say to them.
We don't have enough practice.
Oh, look, a pet shop. And rabbits. Aren't they sweet?
Herb?
What?
That kid's got a parrot in his coat. A real fancy one, too.
So he has.
Could be valuable, a bird like that.
Old Charlie and Petch will give a bit for that.
Just what I was thinking.
Leave it to me.
Right.
Buddy boy! Buddy boy!
What? How dare you address me in those terms?
Take no notice. Everyone's rude around here.
Buddy boy! Buddy boy!
Be silent, you dowdy creature! You dull-feathered son of a one-eyed vulture! You lusterless, ill-bred nincompoop!
My goodness, he certainly knows what to say, doesn't he?
Come on, Janie. I think we ought to move on before they start to fight.
Buddy boy! Buddy boy!
I say, Lord, if this isn't our poor Barrett, what we lost the other week.
So it is I.
Thank you so much for bringing him over to Roots.
You give us back that bird. He's ours.
Good afternoon and thank you. Sorry we can't give you a reward just now. Come back next year.
You give me that bird or I'll...
Or what? Run away, little girl.
Little girl, be careful. Oh, do please let us have him.
Oh, do please go away and leave our bird alone.
Do, don't let him go. I'll fetch the police.
Bear in a pigeon's neck. He ain't worth tuppence anyhow.
Don't hurt him, please.
I wouldn't hurt him. I'm ashamed of you, Herb. Tell you what, young missus. You give me half a shiner and the bird's yours.
Half a what?
Half a sov. Half a quid.
We haven't got that much.
And anyhow, he's our bird.
Oh, Phoenix, you do something, please.
With pleasure. Hearken to me, you sons of misfortune.
He talks and all.
Makes him more valuable.
Restore me at once to my young acolytes if you wish to escape unscathed.
Oh, how I teach a parrot to talk like that?
Parrot? You hooligans! One more insult like that, and my revenge will fall upon you.
I don't like it.
I shall inform the proper authorities. Who pinched my gold ticket off the old bloke in Chancery Lane?
That wasn't me, that was him!
And who sneaked the lady's handbag in Bell Court?
Oh, no, not me, I swear, Your Honour!
Let go, let go!
Oh!
certainly. But I did not think it dignified to get warm about a little thing like that.
There's the main street.
Do you see what I see?
I see it. I see it.
A phoenix.
My temple. My temple. My image in stone and iron, too. Didn't I tell you there was a temple of mine in this city? A great temple. A mighty temple. Take me in. Announce my presence.
Hold on. Don't get so excited. It's only a fire insurance office.
Fire for my altars?
No, you don't understand. When people's houses burn down, the phoenix gives them new ones. Father told me that.
Take me in at once. I expect to be obeyed. New houses arising from the ashes of the old. My priests do good work for the sons of men.
The sons of men have to pay, you know, a little every year.
To maintain my priests, naturally. Lead on at once. Inquire for the high priest. Tell him to take us to the inner sanctuary.
What are we going to do? If he wants us to take him in there,
I suppose we'll have to.
But there aren't any priests. He'll be terribly disappointed.
I'm sure he won't be. Not the phoenix. He'll make it all right.
Lead on, I say. Lead on at once.
What do you want?
Ask to see the High Priest.
Who's that?
We would like to see the High Priest, please.
Thank you very much. Good morning.
We must see someone. He'll be so disappointed. The High Priest, please.
I'm afraid I can't help you. Please leave quietly. Oh, sir, some young persons.
Oh, well. Hello there. What are you looking for? Fire insurance?
Not quite.
No, you're just about the age of my eldest son. I have three of my own, you know.
Yes, sir.
What can I do for you?
Inner sanctuary.
I beg your pardon?
We have something to show you. You'll be very interested.
That's right, but this is rather a public place.
He doesn't want to dazzle everyone. Hmm? Your insurance company will be very pleased.
Indeed. Well, if you say so. You may come with me.
Now, there is a dome to be proud of. So tastefully decorated. How they do worship me here. This way, please. What is it you have to show me?
Well, I know you'll be awfully surprised. We don't want you to be upset and have a fit or anything. But Robert, he's my young brother, has a... Well, I suppose when you called your company the Phoenix, you never thought there was a real one. But there is.
Ah, yes, I understand. You've come across some old curio in the shape of a phoenix. Perhaps you wish to sell it to us. I'm sure the board would be very pleased to consider. What is it?
Behold, O bearded one, I am the head of your house.
I knew it would be too much for him.
Let all who dwell within my temple mark truly what they see and worship as they should. I have spoken. Spoken. Spoken.
What an extraordinarily fine bird. I don't think I've ever seen one quite like that before.
Indeed you have not. I am the one and only Phoenix. I have come to my temple to receive your homage.
Quite, sir, quite. And in the absence of our chairman, perhaps I might be permitted to... What am I saying? I really don't feel quite myself. For a moment, I thought that bird was speaking to me, said it was the Phoenix, and that I should pay homage.
It did. And you should.
One moment. Mackenzie! Come here, quickly. Now, take a look at that bird and tell me what you think.
All presently correct, sir. Awaiting your orders, sir.
Thank you, my man. The temple guard, I take it? Very smart turnout. But fasten your top button.
Oh, yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Begging your pardon, sir.
And that... Hey!
Good gracious. It's true. Oh, I do beg your pardon for ever having doubted you.
You are forgiven. Now, convey me to the inner sanctuary.
The inner... Oh, you mean the boardroom?
If that is what you call the inmost court.
Mackenzie?
Sir?
The doors.
Your arm, if you please.
Now where?
To the high altar, of course, where the fire burns. Remove that graven image. I am here in person.
Oh. Mackenzie!
I am ready to receive my worshippers. Let them enter!
What's he expect now?
I don't know.
Listen.
Let us raise our voice and sing the praises of the Phoenix King. In classes 1 and 2 and 3, oh, trust in him, for kind is he. Let us raise our voice and sing the praises of the Phoenix King. In classes 1 and 2 and 3, oh, trust in him, for kind is he. Class 1, for private dwelling house, for household goods and shops allows, provided these are built of brick or stone, and tile and slate it thick. Thatched dwellings and their whole contents we deal with, also with their rents. Oh, glorious Phoenix, look and see that these are dealt with in Class 3. When people's homes are burnt away, they never have a cent to pay. If they have done as they should do, oh, Phoenix, and have honored you. Oh, golden Phoenix, fairest bird, Phoenix, just to honor you.
splendid. You are most kind.
I say, this will make a good story in tomorrow's papers.
If anyone believes it.
Absolute security, no liability. All kinds of property insured against fire. Terms most favorable.
Expenses reasonable.
Moderate rates for annual insurance.
Yes. That is enough. I am most gratified.
Gentlemen, we are gathered here today on an occasion without parallel in the annals of this company. Our respected Phoenix...
Head of the house?
I was coming to that. Head of this ancient house has done us the honor to come among us.
Hear, hear!
I know, and you know, that our aim has always been to be worthy of that eminent bird whose name we bear. Three cheers, gentlemen, for the head of the house.
Hip hip! Hooray! Hip hip! Hooray!
I don't believe it myself. Hooray.
I said it would be all right.
High priest, priests and acolytes, it gives me great pleasure to find myself here in my own temple, enjoying the worship which, modest and unassuming creature that I am, I confess I most justly deserve.
It's nearly tea time.
And now, gentlemen, I must leave you. Never have I met a nicer, pleasanter spoken lot of temple attendants. I bid you all good day.
One, two, three.
Oh, golden Phoenix, fairest bird, the whole great world has often heard of all the splendid things we do. Great Phoenix, just to honor you.
It was just a dream.
A dream? But they weren't asleep.
I think they were anyway. Anyhow, I expect they all agreed the less said the better.
I think you're right. Although it was a bit of a triumph for him.
You will be glad to know that I have composed another ode to myself. For beauty and for modest worth, the phoenix has never had its equal on earth. I know the second line is a bit long, but do not worry. I shall get it right when I have had a rest. Being worshipped is so exhausting.